asked kind of how did we schedule a lot of these for the men's team, they elected to go first because of flight arrangements and things that were already predetermined. He was from Lynnfield, Massachusetts, of course. He's from Hamden, Maine. I don't think he was Mr. Lynnfield, Massachusetts basketball, so we have to make sure we get that right, of course. Gustav Sryesen.
Maine,
and that's something that I think was important to him. It looks like Coach Dickson serving as the official today as a deep three-pointer. Spencer Klein today. Yesterday, we had a running tally for those of you who didn't join us. Menard from straight on puts it up and in.
Sweet stroke there.
Blue team jumps ahead 13-11 to the hands of Chris Ball. Ball puts a move on Gustav Sryesen, but right. Up and down the college's staff directory that has really done a great job.
And you know, you talk about the testing. I know Mara Marshall, with testing our students and our student athletes, over 10,000 tests conducted during the first semester. Hey, and Griffin, at some point too, you're going to have to tell us about your experience in the bubble for that tournament down in Connecticut, actually, that was on ESPN. I know you...
Casino and Resort.
And for all the Anselmians, I'll tell you, Griffin proudly wore St. A's pullover as well as a St. Anselm mask, actually.
Absolutely,
so representing...
St. Anselm branding, so it was definitely good to represent St. Anselm with a nice jumper there by Chris Paul. Chris Paul up to 16 of his team's 30 points here in the early going, so... Urbancic. Puts it up and hits on a dish from Gustav Sryesen.
He's got 6 points.
And the blue team up 35-32, just under halfway through the first half. And that's Lozier. And he hits. Back and forth they go here from Stoutenburg Gymnasium, 35-35. Up Gustav Sryesen with the offensive board. Menard, deep three, and he hits. Another assist for Gustav Sryesen. The ice hockey scrimmages yesterday in Sullivan Arena. Lozier hits a three, and it's just back and forth here. And this is the type of action you like to see. We saw a lot of this. I mean, it was quite the storm at a block there by McGlashan on Lozier.
And impress the alumni who are watching at home.
Becker with a nice play and the foul. Nice play there by Matt Becker.
And a better human being to boot. I mean, really, just an incredible human being. And, you know, you think about his board of trustees and...
Steal by Lozier here, going the other way. He'll lay it up and in for the white team. Oh, we have three injured student-athletes on the side. Long distance pass laid up and in by Bryce Lozier.
Although we talked yesterday...
Tradition of delivering that experience.
Right, over 130 years.
Yep, exactly. Yeah. You know, on both teams, I'm sure, you know... Long days for some of the goalies yesterday.
How many shots are we talking about? The women's game, over 80. If I was writing the script, if it had been the NHL or the NBA, they probably would have, for the drama, they would have called it. Certainly the NBA. Almost like being a Rangers fan.
Yep.
Been a long time since they hoisted the Holy Grail, Stanley Cup.
Nice three-pointer there by Bryce Lozier. Lamone and a former men's basketball student-athlete here on the Hilltop. And, I mean, that space out there, if you haven't seen it, check out our website. The brand-new jumper by Menard, reeled in by Charlie Borstel. Oh, driving layup.
Oh,
and a blocking foul.
And you know what's significant about this? That puts him at...
Oates in the national poll as well. So, again, St. Anselm home to nationally regarded. That was quite the block there by Lozier. That's a rejection.
Hello,
right there.
Hello, how are you?
Lozier threw it. Urbancic threw the shot up, but I mean that was, we have to check the masonry over there on the side of the gymnasium.
They'll be
the Hilltop here in 2017. And here's Chris Paul, little 3-on-1 action. Becker in with the flush. Whoa. Matt Becker.
That was nice. That was sweet.
Puts the white team up 90-80. Quite the run here for the white team. Urbancic puts it up and hits the blue team. Respond. Officer Yesen. McGlashan for three, and he hits the blue team in within four, 90-86. We said he was from Lynnfield. Everybody's from Lynnfield, according to me in the starting lineup, as a three-point basket there by Arbuckle. And look at that.
Great.
It was a 10-point lead.
Unbelievable. Just like that. Blink of an eye.
It's toppled. Steve Drescher, of course, just a really, really great guy and a great assistant for the Hawks basketball team.
He said that.
Leave it alone here as blue team goes ahead 95-94.
Oh, great.
And Chris Paul looks like he got that, and I believe that was Chris. sends it back to Arbuckle. I think you're going to, yeah, I was going to say, you know what's coming here, and that's a drain three, 104 to 101 with 27.6
seconds. I said it may be over, but, you know, you never know. And
as an off-balance three by Menard will not go. Lozier carries it out to midcourt. He will not drive the basket. And there it is, the white team from St. Anselm College, 107. The blue team, 101.
Yeah, that's sort of a normal scrimmage set for us. You know, obviously during practice you don't have real referees, so we're the ones that have to make the call. So, you know, in terms of wins and losses, it's like I think it's sort of what the year is, right? There's the whole year is now just about development. There's no such thing as wins and losses. So I think this was actually pretty good for the kids. You know, people got a chance to see some of our new guys. I know we had a lot of guys that were out hurt that couldn't play, but people haven't seen the freshmen and they haven't seen Owen. And obviously you got to see some of our guys. So what's become typical for us, it was a close game, and I hope we kept people entertained. You know, so our older guys, you know, you got similar stuff out of Ty. You know, Ty's proven. Goose is proven. You know, Miles was sitting out, but those four guys are all conference caliber players. Obviously, I think Chris Paul's an MVP caliber kind of player in this league. And then the key to this unit is going to be what do these other guys do? What does Matt Becker do? What does Bryce Lozier do? What does Owen McGlashan do? You know, what does Alonzo Jackson do? You know, what does Joey Belli do? Those are the things you haven't really seen. I'm pretty comfortable with our top four guys and excited about the contribution that I think we would get from those other guys. So this is a good team. You know, this team, if you know, we're not going to be able to compete this year, but you know, those guys are coming back next year, we'll put a good, really good unit out on the court, I think. I just think the future, especially for those two wing players, Becker and Lozier, you know, Matt Becker, I think I said it to somebody, you know, if we started a team today, Matt Becker would be the starting wing player with Ty. He basically takes over Danny Evans's role. And we just think the world of him. He's terrific on defense. He makes plays on both ends. He can dribble it. He can pass it. And he gets the ball to the basket. He's got a really high IQ. And Bryce Lozier, I'd say in the last couple of weeks, has really started to play like we thought he would be able to play. I think Bryce has really picked it up recently and, you know, we think he's going to be terrific. So, you know, this gives them an extra year to develop and figure this thing out. And in the end, I think they'll, when it's their turn, they're both going to be really good.